said so many things, and I can't locate him these days because the things he said during election and the things he's doing now are two different things.
But in this regime, 2 years in a row, the finance bill is causing serious problems to Kenyans.
South African opposition politician Julius Malema on Monday, June 24th, 2022, commended the bravery of Kenyans who were protesting against the financial bill 2024. Malema, who is the leader of Economic Freedom Fighters Party, in a statement on X, noted that he is in solidarity with Kenyan youth as they peacefully reject the proposed tax in the bill. Malema said that we commend the bravery of Kenyan protesters and stand with them in their peaceful protest against their exploitative legislation that seeks to impose a crippling tax. According to Julius Malema, Kenya's finance bill, which aimed to raise about $2.5 billion in additional taxes, will undoubtedly raise the cost of living and population in further bordering the people of Kenya. The Economic Freedom Fighters Party leader alleged that the bill is the result of recommendation from the International Monetary Fund, IMF, and the World Bank to the Kenyan government. This therefore part of broader problem faced by many developing nations under the yoke of the IMF and World Bank loans, he noted. He added that the IMF and World Bank have a notorious history of undermining the sovereignty of developing countries through their oppressive loan conditions and treating African economies like lab rats for neoliberal templates. This Bretton Woods institution served as instrument of recolonization and infantilization of the African continent, using African as a pawn in geopolitical wars going on, and imposing austerity measures that cripple through the development, leading to widespread poverty and social unrest to justify the establishment of U.S. military bases in the continent, Malema explained. At the same time, he maintained that the EFF party stand firm for economic freedom and the establishment of robust social awareness safety nets. He further noted that the protests in Kenya are clear in indication that the people are rejecting policies that accelerate their suffering and demand a government that serves their well-being. The EFF leader party also condemned the violence crackdown on peaceful protesters, which has resulted in injuring to innocent citizens at a time when some organizers of the protest were being arrested. The use of tear gases, water cannons, and rubber bullet against citizens exercising their right to protest is unacceptable. We urge the Kenyan government to stand down the police and respect the people's right to peaceful assembly, he stated. Additionally, he called on Kenyan government to ensure all protesters who were arrested are released unconditionally. So, brothers and sisters, this is what going on in one of the, East African country there in Kenya, where we see people are just commenting or in a peaceful way protesting against this financial bill this year, 2024. So, brothers and sisters, you heard the thought from Julius Malema, what he said, and hope you have anything to add on this issue, because what we need now to make the life of our own people in Africa to be better. And citizens must choose better way also to oppose the some issues like this. So let me end here, not speak too much. And if you have anything, please write it in the comment section. This is Fact About Africa. the African channel, share thought and changing problem. And changing narrative. Sometimes we provide the solutions of our own problem because the solution of African is for Africans. Welcome back and welcome to the next episode.